Today we are going to discuss about a new topic from our basic physics syllabus, that is mechanics. Mechanics is a very important classical mechanics branch, which is the base for the most of the physics and most of the quantum physics and the most of the modern physics. So when we throw a ball or you drop something from height, it reaches the earth. Everyone knows this fact. Before hundreds of years, most of the people thought that heavier bodies comes faster than the lighter bodies. Heavy body falls faster according to this Aristotle. But Galilei conducted experiment on a Pisa tower by dropping two different mass objects. He concluded that every body reaches the same time to the ground. After a century or hundreds of years, Isaac Newton conducted experiments with a feather and a coin in a vacuum tube without air resistance. So this feather and coin reaches the ground, bottom of the bottle simultaneously. So it means all the bodies freely coming downward or freely falling simultaneously reaches the ground from a particular height, right? So mechanics is a basic for the understanding of a behavior of the object, right? In this mechanics, we studies different types of behavior of a body, physical body, right? Mechanics is a branch which deals with the behavior of the material bodies under the action of force. This mechanics is divided into dynamics and kinematics. Dynamics is a study of a behavior of the body. Behavior of the body under the action of force or influence of force. So you are studying the behavior of the body with respect to force, then it comes under the dynamics. For example, a body is moving with some velocity. With some velocity means it changes its velocity with respect to time and it covers some distance. It takes some time to cover the particular distance. Initially, at the starting point, it has some velocity. In between the way, it has some different velocities, and at the end point, it has some velocity. So you are studying this object, how the object velocity is changing from point to point, from time to time, right? All these things you are studying, it comes under the kinematics. And the body is moving, increases its velocity, decreases its velocity, it taken much time or less time, its acceleration decreases, acceleration increases. Due to all this, due to the external force, by giving external force, its velocity increases, it moves fast, it takes less time to come reach the destination. If you are applying brake or you are applying external force to stop or resist the body or resist the object, then its velocity decreases and it takes much time to reach the same destination. So here force or you are applying external force plays a vital role. If you are considering this force, why the object is moving fast, why the object is moving slow, why the object's acceleration decreased, why the object acceleration increased, you are considering why the object is moving, means the source of the motion of the object, then it comes under the dynamics. Without considering the source, just you are studying the behavior, all type of behaviors comes under the kinetics. This dynamics also divided into one, kinematics and kinetics. Kinematics is a branch of mechanics study of behavior, motion of the body without reference or without considering the source. Kinetics is a study of a motion of a body with special reference to the reasons like force, masses, they are interact bodies is called as kinetics. And if the body is at a static position or stationary position, then the conditions necessary to keep the body in the equilibrium under the action of force. So you have to put a body in a static position. So you need a external force. The study of this is called as a statics. So these are the some of the basic branches or areas of a body mechanics. In mechanics, we are going to study the behavior of a material bodies under the influence of force, under the influence of without considering the force. All this comes under the mechanics. Here, before understanding the behavior, you need to understand some terminology in the mechanics. What is a particle? What is a body? What is rest position? What is motion? This type of terminology you should know before understanding the concepts of a mechanics. So what is a particle? Particle is an object of negligible mass. The very less negligible mass, then it is called as a particle. The combining of different number of particles a body constructed. So what is body here? A body which is having dimensions and can be considered to consist a infinite number of particles. It's a consist of a number of particles. If you construct or add a different number of particles, then you will get a body. So a body is having some dimension, whether it's a one dimensional, two dimensional, three dimensional, whatever it may be the dimension, it should have dimension, and it's a consist of an infinite of a number of particle is called as a body. So a body is at a place, particular place. For now it is there. You see the body after 1 hour, it is there. You see afternoon, it will be there. You observe at 4 o'clock or 5 o'clock or evening 8 o'clock, it will be there. Means there is no change in its position. Right? So a body position does not change with respect to time and its surroundings. That type of body is called as a body is at rest position. A body is at rest position whose position does not changes with respect to time and respect to surroundings. This is rest position. Examples: a book placed on a table, right? A pen put in your bag, right? your chair position, this all comes under the rest positions. So what is the motion? The position, for example, a body is, now this book is on the table at the corner of right side upper corner or right side corner in the middle of the table. I am applying some force on this body. I am pushing this body book, so it moves to the left side. From right to left, it changes. At 10 o'clock, it is at the right place. At 10 o'clock, 2 minutes, it is in a left place. So, its position changes with respect to what? With respect to time. As time changes, whether it's a less time or much time, time changes, its position changes. That type of bodies are called as a, the body is called, said to be in a motion. The position of the body changes with respect to time and respect to its surroundings is called as a body is in a motion. Examples for the motion of a body: a moving car, a ball rolling on a table, aeroplane, a flying bird comes under, all this comes under the motion of a body. Car, moving aeroplane, flow of water, moving air, etc. Everything comes under the motion position. So everybody is moving on a floor or horizontally they are moving. So we can study the velocity of a body, acceleration of a body. Acceleration, velocity, time taken and covered distance, all these things we can cover in the study of this mechanics, right? So if the body is on a surface or plane area or horizontally, the object is moving, then we can study the velocity, initial velocity, final velocity, acceleration, time taken, covered distance, all these comes under the study of the behavior. With considering the force, it comes under the dynamics. In our syllabus, we have the kinematics, right? Here, we are going to study the object projections. What are the different types of projections? What are the equations for the projections? How the projected body or projectile moves in a particular path, how much time takes to reach its maximum position, and how much time takes to come down from the maximum position, and how much distance it covers, means horizontally how much distance covers it, a horizontal range, all these things covers under this chapter. So we have the relations. You studied in your high school equations of motions. Equations of motions are V equals to U plus AT, S equals to UT plus half AT square, V square minus U square equal to 2AS, SN equals to U plus A into N minus half. These are the equations of motion. These equations, by using these equations, you can study, you can extract any value which you want when the object is moving on a horizontal surface or horizontal plane. If the body is projected up, thrown upward direction, what happens? It ultimately comes downward. Why it is coming downward? Or lift an object to certain height and release it. It falls downward only. Because there is a attractive pulling force is there toward the center of mass. Due to this attractive pulling force, force of attraction of Earth, every object comes down. So the gravity, this is called as a gravity, and Earth's attraction pulling force is acting on all the bodies on total whole Earth. If a body is freely falling from certain height, its initial its velocity increases because of uniform acceleration produced by this pulling force of attraction. When the body is thrown up, projected upward from the surface of the Earth, its velocity decreases. Finally, at certain height, its velocity becomes zero. When its velocity becomes zero, then it comes down only because it has no velocity to move further. In these both cases, when the projected up at certain height, while it is going up, its velocity decreases. At certain height, its velocity becomes zero. From that point, it falls down. While it is coming downward direction, its velocity increases gradually, acceleration increases. In these both the cases, acceleration in the body is due to the gravitational force of Earth, gravitational pulling force of attraction of force. Gravitational attractive force is acting on the body. Due to this, the acceleration changes. Here, the body is, acceleration is produced in a freely falling body due to the gravitational force of attraction towards the center of the Earth. This is called as a acceleration due to gravity. This acceleration due to gravity is denoted by small g. The average value of a small g is 9.8 meter per second square. The value of g, gravitational acceleration, is constant for the all the bodies at a place. Now we are here, right? At this place, if you find the gravitational acceleration by using any body with different masses, you will get the same value because the value of g is constant for the all the bodies at this place. If you change, go from here to another place, not 10 kilometers, 5 kilometers, go from Telangana to New Delhi, New Delhi to Meghalaya, Meghalaya to Gujarat, or go further other countries, America, Germany, Japan, Bangladesh, Nepal, Bhutan, China, then the value is differ from G value. But at that particular place, the value of G is constant for all the bodies. The value of G changes from place to place. It has a maximum value at a poles. When you go from equator to north pole or south pole, the value increases. From equator to towards north pole or south pole, g value increases. The maximum g value is 9.83 and minimum is 9.73 meter per second square. The acceleration due to gravity of a body is always directed toward downward, toward the center of the Earth. The body is projected up, our body is coming downward direction. Irrespective of this direction, the gravitational acceleration always acts downward. While the body falling freely, its velocity increases. So g is taken as a plus. Here, if the body is falling downward direction, this is the Earth center, the pulling force is toward this direction and body is also coming the same direction, therefore g value is taken as plus. If the body is projected up, this is the center of Earth, the project, this is surface, from the surface we are projecting a body, it is going upward, but gravitational pulling force is downward, that's why g is taken as a minus. For upward, a body is freely falling body, it is plus g. If the body is going upward direction, it is the minus g. Value is taken as minus because the pulling force and the body going direction, are the pulling force direction and body motion directions are opposite. That's why it is taken as minus g, negative. And when the body is coming downwards, it is taken as plus because the pulling force direction and motion of the body direction is same. That's why g is taken as a positive. Here we have different projection. You are throwing a object to certain height, it is going up and coming down. If a body is thrown with certain initial velocity and certain angle, if the body is projected with a certain initial velocity and certain angle, then it is called as a projection. If you are throwing a body with certain initial velocity and certain angle, then the process is called as a projection, and the projected body is called as a projectile. If you are throwing a stone, you are throwing a stone is called as a projection, and stone itself is called as a projectile. This body allowed to move under the influence of gravity. So when you are throwing a body, for example, you are throwing a body of mass m with initial velocity u, while it is going up, its velocity decreases, its acceleration decreases. At certain point its velocity becomes zero. This is due to the gravitational pulling force towards the center of earth or downward direction. When velocity becomes zero, it is not able to move further from that particular point, then it, under the influence of gravity, comes down, freely falls. So its velocity increases. While it is falling down, its velocity increases because the pulling force and the coming direction are same. While it is going up, its movement of motion is on other direction and pulling force is on the other direction. That's why velocity decreases. The study of motion of a projectile is called as a ballistics. Who is the father of ballistics in India? Abdul Kalam. APJ Abdul Kalam is called as a missile man of India. He is the father of ballistics in India. The study, science of a study of the motion of a particle, projectile, motion of a projectile is called as a ballistics. And the path, in which path the projectile is moving, the path is called as a trajectory. For example, a bomb dropped from a moving aeroplane, a bat, a ball hit by a cricket player, a javelin thrown by an athlete, a cricket ball thrown by a fielder, a bullet fired from a gun, a stone thrown upward at an angle, certain different angle with a horizontal. These are the examples for the projectile. A golf ball hit, a jet of water from a rubber tube, a football kicked by a player, a body thrown by you, everything comes under the projectile. Here we have different types of projections. Majorly, different type of projections or projectile motions are three types. One is a vertical projection, another one is a horizontal projection and third one is a oblique projection. Vertical projection means the projecting a object upward direction making 90 degrees angle. This is called as a vertical projection. You are throwing a ball exactly upward direction, which makes 90 degree angle with a surface or floor. It is called as a vertical projection. If you are throwing a ball from a top of a tower or from a building horizontally with that surface, then it is called as a horizontal projection. For example, this is a building. You are throwing an object in this direction. This is the surface, right? This is the surface of the object. So you are throwing this body in this direction. It comes in this direction and reaches the ground. This is called as a horizontal projection. And next one is oblique projection. Here a body is projected with certain height. Body is projected with a certain velocity and some angle. So if you are projecting a body with this from here, the body is projected from this point, right, with velocity u, initial velocity. The body goes in this direction and reaches the ground. This type of, if you are projecting with this direction, it is horizontal. If you are projecting this direction, it is 90 degrees vertical, 0 degrees horizontal, 0 degrees, 90 degrees, other than 0 and 90 degrees. It is not equals to 0 and not equals to 90. Then it is called as a horizontal oblique projection. So angle, a body is projected with initial velocity u and some angle theta is called as a oblique projection. Here theta is not equals to 0 or not equals to 90. If it is equals to 0, it is called as a, if theta equals to 0, it is vertical. Sorry, theta equals to 90, it is vertical. Theta equals to 0, it is horizontal. Theta is not equals to 0 and not equals to 90, but theta has some different value, then it is called as a oblique projection. Here in our syllabus we have horizontal projection and oblique projection. So we will discuss about horizontal projection and oblique projection in this chapter. First we get to understand what is horizontal projection, what is oblique projection, then we will enter into the equation parts. See the picture here. This is AB. AB is the height of a building, H, right? The object is thrown in this direction with initial velocity u, certain initial velocity u. It falls under the influence of a g value, gravitational acceleration value, gravitational force. This type of projection are called as a horizontal projection. A body is projected horizontally with certain velocity from certain height. Body moves under the influence of gravitational force is called as a horizontal projection. The horizontal projection examples: a bullet fired from a gun horizontally. For example, here this is a gun. The bullet is coming in this direction. If you put a gun in this direction, that is different. So the horizontally fired bullet, a bomb released from a aeroplane. A aeroplane is moving, right? Aeroplane is moving, then the bombs are released. The ball bomb falls in this direction. It is a horizontal projection. A ball rolling on a horizontal table. So this is a horizontal table. Consider this is a horizontal table, right? A ball is here, it is rolling in this direction. So ball is rolling. This is also horizontal projection, and at this point it goes down, right? This is also horizontal. And carom board coins falls in a target point, right? It falls in the, this comes under the horizontal projection. These are the examples for the horizontal projection. And horizontal projection is the body is projected with certain initial velocity from certain height with 0 degrees or parallel to the surface or parallel to the ground is called as a horizontal projection. And next projection is according to our syllabus. In our syllabus we have oblique projection. We will discuss extensively in this chapter about oblique projection. So what is oblique projection? A body, observe this, a body is projected with certain initial velocity with certain angle other than 90 degrees is called as it has initial velocity, some angle, then it is called as a oblique projection, right? Here the path covered by the oblique projection path covered by the object is called as a trajectory. This is the origin O. The object is projected with initial velocity u in this direction, then it goes in, follows this direction and comes to the ground. Initial velocity, angle is theta, O, P, for example, X. Right? This is angle, initial velocity. So this O, P, A, this is the line I am showing this in red. This is the trajectory of a body. So here, the object, the oblique projection is defined as the body is projected with a certain initial velocity and certain angle other than 90. So here the path covered by the object is called as a trajectory. So we have a question on this path equation of a trajectory in oblique projection, which is more very important question for the examination point of view. So to understand the oblique projection, see this figure. Object is thrown with the initial velocity u. Object is thrown with the initial velocity u. It makes angle theta. So it's a oblique projection. The angle is other than 90. So the object is describes a trajectory O, E, B. This is a trajectory of the body, right? And it reaches the ground B at after some time t. This type of projection is called as a oblique projection. The velocity of a oblique projection can be resolved. Here this is the resultant velocity u. U is a resultant velocity. This velocity can be resolved into its components. One component along the horizontal direction or OX axis, and another along OY axis. So here OX along X axis it is UX, along Y axis it is UY. So So along x axis it is u cos theta. U is divided into components u cos theta. Along y axis u sin theta is the velocity component. The horizontal component is u cos theta. Vertical component is u sin theta. Right? The trajectory can be of a body can be regarded as a combination of these two velocities. Due to these two velocities, ux and uy, here ux and uy, due to combination of these two velocities, the object is following this path. Because at a simultaneous time, the object is moving forward and moving upward. Due to the combination of these two components of velocity, it is following this direction. This is the resultant velocity u. If the air resistance or viscosity of air is neglected, then this ux component at any point ux is constant. Ux is a constant, it does not change. Ux cannot be changed if you neglect the air resistance. But the uy component, here the when the object is going up, uy component up to the maximum height point A, it is moving up. So due to the gravitational acceleration or due to gravitational force, the object velocity decreases. At this point velocity becomes zero. When velocity becomes zero, it comes down. So here y component, vertical component, acts downward direction. So only the downward component has a influence of gravity and horizontal component remains unchanged throughout the path. Throughout the path from here to there, u is constant. U constant, v changes due to the gravitational value, gravitational acceleration. Right? So this is a, here assume the body. The body is projected with a certain initial velocity. It makes some angle, and u cos theta, u sin theta are the two velocities. Due to the combination of these two, the object is moving or following the particular trajectory. So if the horizontal distance traveled in a t seconds, see horizontal, when the body reaches point P, for example, body comes to this point P, at P this is the distance covered in y direction, this is the distance, and in the x direction that is the distance, right? So observe that if the body reaches a certain height from this is at point P, this is the body reaches at point P after some time t, then this is the x direction, x distance covered, and this is the y distance it covered. So what is the x distance here? X distance is x. For example, take x distance is x. So see the picture here. This is the distance x covered in a x direction. And what is the distance covered in the y direction? That is the, this is the direction, distance covered in the y direction after time t, right? So horizontal distance traveled in the time t is x, and vertical distance is traveled in the time t is y. So here horizontal distance traveled by the body. So what is the travel distance? X equals to travel distance, horizontally travel distance equals to horizontal velocity into time. So what is horizontal velocity? Here horizontal distance is x, horizontal velocity is u cos theta along ox into t. So x equals to u cos theta into t. From this, x equals to u cos theta into t. So time taken to cover that particular x distance in horizontal direction, t equals to u cos theta, right? This is the x and t values in a horizontal direction. Here the object is moving simultaneously horizontally and vertically. So the vertical distance traveled, vertical distance traveled by the body is v. Here this is the body is at P, means at P this is the vertical distance traveled by the body. This is the vertical distance, right? So vertical distance is y. So what is the y value after time t? So y equals to, from s equals to ut plus half at square formula, we have equations of motions s equals ut plus half at square. Here initial s is a distance y in the along y axis, u is the initial velocity u sin theta, and the object is going up, so acceleration is taken as minus g. The object is moving up, so taken as minus g, and time t is taken as t. So distance is y along y axis, time taken is t, u is u sin theta, and a acceleration equals to minus g. Substituting these values in s equals to ut plus half a t square formula. Substituting all s, u, g, t values in this s equals to ut plus half a t square formula, you will get y equals to u sin theta into t minus half g t square. Minus half gt square, because s equals to y, u equals to u, t equals to t, half plus half, g is minus g, that's why minus g. So this is the y value, displacement along a vertical distance. Substitute the t value and in this equation, so you will get y equals to u sin theta. What is the value of t from equation? T equals to x by u cos theta, so into x by u cos theta minus half g t square. T is x by u cos theta whole square. So from this you will get u sin theta u cos theta into x, right, minus 1 by g x square u square cos square theta. You will get from this sin by cos equals to tan theta, u gets cancelled. So y equals to, from this you will get y equals to tan theta into x minus g 2 u square cos square theta into x square. I am writing all the terms together and x values at different. So if you observe this tan theta, and these total constant values are taken as constants a and b. I am taking this a and b as a constants. So a equals to tan theta, tan theta equals to a, and b equals to g by 2 u square cos square theta. These are the taken as constant. Then y equals to, this equation becomes as a y equals to ax square, sorry, ax minus bx square. This is the y equals to ax minus bx square is a equation of parabola. That's why the path of a projectile projected in oblique projection is a parabola. So path of the equation is parabola. So in this next chapter, next class, we will discuss about what is the maximum height covered by a projectile in a oblique projection. What is the time taken to go from the projected point to maximum height? What is the time taken to fall down from the projected point? And what is the total time of flight? What is the horizontal range? All these areas are covered in a next class. So for this class, we have an assignment. So here assignment questions are, define projectile, give example. So these are the most important questions in an examination point of view. So definitions and examples are plays a vital role in this examination point of view. So define projectile, give examples. If you by heart 2 or 3 examples, it is very difficult to represent in the examination. So try to understand our daily life involved examples. You can write any example in examination, no need to buy it from a book only. Define projectile, give examples. Define horizontal projectile, give examples. Define oblique projection, write some examples. And derive an expression for the path of the projectile projected in oblique projection. This is a last one. Last question is a essay question, which is the most important topic from this chapter, and all the definitions also very important, right? Thank you. We will meet in next class with discussion about the horizontal and oblique projection, other equations. Thank you.